From business to entertainment, I sit down with folks who have reached their own level of success to discuss their accomplishments, the lessons they've learned, and the challenges they faced along the way. You're listening to The Jordan James Show. I'd like to start today's episode with a quote from the best-selling author Eckhart Tolle. Time isn't precious at all, because it is an illusion. What you perceive as precious is not time, but the one point that is out of time, the now. The more you are focused on time, past, and future, the more you miss the now, the most precious thing there is. Living in the present moment allows you to be thankful for everything. If our happiness at this time consists mainly of memories and expectations, we'll only be vaguely aware of the present moment. If we do this a lot, we won't be able to be fully conscious of what goes on around us. I'm Jordan James, and today's guest is Matthew Edmondson, who began his career at the age of 9 when he was cast in the stage production of Les Mis. Since then, he has gone on to star in a string of plays, TV shows, and films, danced competitively, recorded music, and most recently launched a personal health and fitness brand called Fit Performance with his business partner. Matthew is the epitome of an entrepreneur and says that he likes to do everything and always gives it his very best effort. All right, Matthew Edmondson, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me, man. Thank you so much. This is awesome.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. So actor, singer, dancer, musician, entrepreneur. Is there a title that you don't have, man?
I don't know. I just like doing everything.
Absolutely.
Whatever I get into, I go full force. So
yeah, for sure. I would almost like label you as a serial entrepreneur. Like, you kind of seem to be all over the place. And once you finish something or once you've accomplished something there, you just move on to the next big thing, you know?
Yeah, I would definitely agree with that. And it's actually something that I've kind of found out and developed through the past like 2 years almost. Because I started getting into other things, you know, I started branching more into the fitness at that point. And then I kind of realized that I just kind of go wherever, you know, the wind takes me.
Yeah, I love that. Excellent. So you've accomplished so much in your life already at such a young age. What are some of the highlights of your career so far?
I would probably say I probably have two highlights as of right now, and it would definitely be being able to go throughout my acting career. I've been able to go to Vancouver and LA for specific kids award shows, and I've been fortunate enough to actually come home with a couple of awards. So that's probably been a big highlight for me, being able to go there and have that experience and be in Vancouver and in LA and kind of do that, and as well as going to college. Just going through college, growing up acting and being in the acting and music world. It was kind of said that like not a lot of actors and musicians go to college. So in my mind growing up, I was like, oh, I'm probably never going to go. And now the fact that I'm about to graduate in April is like a huge milestone for me, I think. So,
oh, wow. Congratulations,
yeah,
dude. Same for me.
Yeah. So, but yeah,
are you currently at Durham College right now?
Durham College. Yep.
Okay. And what are you studying there?
Fitness and health promotion.
Oh, wow. So that kind of goes hand in hand with what you're doing now.
Yeah. Yeah. 100%.
Awesome. Wow. Good for you, dude.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
So let's just jump right into a bit of your origin story rather. So where did you come from, and where did you go to school, and what are you currently working on?
Yeah. So I really started off, I grew up in Bowmanville, Ontario. My parents had a bowling alley in Bowmanville. So I really grew up being at that bowling alley a lot. So I was always there, and I naturally was just a very, I guess, just outgoing kid. I would talk to everyone. I was showing up in costumes. So I would always be wearing either a Spider-Man costume or like a Ninja Turtle costume. And I would pretend to either be Spider-Man or a Ninja Turtle. So I guess I got my performing start there. And then I guess my parents noticed my energy, and they put me in dance. And I did competitive dancing for a lot of years, and that translated into doing musical theater, and it translated into, you know, my love for music and acting and things like that. And then I went to high school at O'Neill, which is a performing arts school in Oshawa. So I was there in the performing arts program throughout my 4 years of high school. Then did a lot of filming. I took about 2 years off after high school and just really, really grinded and focused on my acting and music. So lots of auditions and things like that. And then it got to a point where I really started kind of falling in love with fitness. And that kind of started in high school with a fitness class. It was nice because I kind of stopped competitive dance at that point. So it kept me active and it was moving my body, and it was kind of like a therapy for me. So I really started to get passionate about fitness. Then, yeah, after the 2 years, I was like, you know what? I've been working out all these 2 years as well as doing my acting and music. Why not go to school, maybe take a break from the acting and music and still do it, but kind of step back for a minute and just go into something else and just see what it's like. Go to college for fitness and health and do that kind of stuff and kind of have that as like a side hustle in a way. And right. It grew into more passion.
Absolutely. Just following your passions wherever they may take you, right?
100%. My goal is to just do what I love and to still remain comfortable, you know?
Absolutely. I like that. So just going back a little bit to your acting career. So you started in the industry at age 9.
Yes.
Am I correct? Yeah. So yes, is that when 100%. You landed a role in Les Mis, right? Was that your first,
yes,
your first role?
100%. Yes. Yes, it was. Yes,
nice.
It was. That's awesome that you know that. That's so cool. I did Les Mis. I played Gavroche. That was the first thing I'd ever booked. I actually still remember getting the call. And then this guy was like, oh, my name is Michael. And I was like, who is this? And I got really scared. I was like 8 or 9 at the time. But I still remember getting that call. So that started off with theater, started off with Les Mis, and then branched into commercials and film and television. I still did a lot of musical theater, but television really took over for acting for me.
Yeah.
Just grew from there.
Yeah, because I mean, you booked a lot of roles, like stage productions, even like you were, what were you, yeah, Troy in High School Musical, Oliver, yeah, Oliver, Aladdin in Aladdin. Yeah. Dude, these are big roles.
Yeah, yeah, man. It was super fun. It was a blast.
Yeah. And so what were some of your most memorable times working on those stage productions?
Oh, man.
What kind of lessons did you learn as well?
I feel like some of the biggest lessons that I've learned, I guess, overall through all of that experience was, I guess, communication, a lot of like communication skills and just professionalism, I guess, because I was so young at the time and being on set or being in these productions with, adult crew and that kind of stuff at such, right, such a young age, it was, I kind of grew up very quickly because of that. So I think it taught me a lot of lessons just about responsibility, time management, especially because I missed so much school throughout elementary school and high school. I missed so much because of acting. So really being able to focus on time management, balancing assignments and still wanting to have a social life and do my acting. So I would definitely think those two, responsibility and time management, would be the biggest lessons that I've definitely learned throughout that experience.
Right.
For sure.
And then moving on from that, you also started to land lots of roles on television as well. You were, yeah, in Heroes Reborn, Private Eyes, and The Next, yeah, Step, just to name a few. Of all those roles that you've had in your past, what would you say is your favorite, and which one was probably the most challenging for you?
I feel like my most challenging and favorite could be separate. And I would say my most challenging was I had a role in a TV movie called Group Home. And my character's name was Jesse, and he was a very, very dark character. I kind of have a tendency to play a very upbeat, kind of myself, energetic kind of guy, either like comic relief or just the energetic guy. So to play, this darker role, especially cause he was kind of the bad guy, our antagonist essentially. So,
right,
to do that was completely different for me. And I think I was about 15 or no, I was 16 at the time. So even at 16, taking on something like that was fairly challenging, but I love challenges. So I embraced it full force and went from there. My favorite role? That's a hard question, man. I would have to say I did a pilot, which we're actually trying to shop right now, shop around, because we're trying to get a season lifted and greenlit. But I would have to say I played a role of Jordan in a show called Coming Distractions, and if you could write me and my quirkiness and weirdness into a character, it would be him. So I think it's my favorite because I just get to be myself. I get to be my goofy self, and I always love that. I love making people smile. So. If I can do that with the role, that's my favorite.
Yeah. I mean, I actually had the pleasure of watching the pilot online of Coming Distractions.
Yes, yes. What'd you think?
I loved it, man. I loved it. What a cool, I actually worked in a theater myself as a teenager. So, I mean,
yes, yes.
Yeah. I feel like you're playing me, dude. Like that's me who you're playing.
Yes, that's the goal. That's the goal. I think there's such a cool market and a cool audience for this because no one really talks about people that work in movie theaters. And I think it's just a really cool thing to touch on. Cool concept, cool idea, especially an independent movie theater too, you know, struggling to keep up with the big box theaters and things like that. So that's awesome. I didn't know that.
I mean, it was a fun job too.
At first it was kind of something that that my mom had put me in. I was at a younger age and she brought up the idea of it. My mom actually grew up doing theater herself. And has been agents for different agencies and things. Now she does more like casting directing now, but she kind of brought up the idea and I didn't really know what it was at the time. All I knew was I get to like dress up and be something else. So I was all for it. And then I think as I got older and I kind of really understood acting and the craft of acting, I think what really started to draw me in even more and really create a passion for it was just understanding the craft. Because acting at the end of the day, all it is just being present in the moment. You're not thinking about the past. You're not thinking about the future. You're just present in the moment. And I think being present in the moment in general is just huge when it comes to overall happiness and things like that. So being able to pull that out, it's kind of like meditation in a sense, right? Where you're present, you're just focused in that moment. So yeah, it's almost kind of like, I think that's what that really draws me to it. Just that sense of presence.
Right. Now you just mentioned meditation. Are you one to meditate quite often?
I try to as much as I can. Yeah. Because I like to do so many things, it can be daunting. It can be a little bit overwhelming sometimes for sure. I'd be lying if I said it wasn't, just trying to manage everything. So, it's really nice to meditate cause I'm a very ambitious individual, so I have lots of ideas and lots of things going on at the same time. So to kind of shut that down, close my eyes and just listen to music and be present in the moment, not thinking about yesterday, not thinking about an hour from now, just being present is huge. It calms me down, I guess. It just lets me breathe, you know? So I don't know.
Yeah. And what are some of the benefits that you would say that you reap from being able to meditate?
I would definitely say it can help with a lot of, if you're feeling any stress, any anxieties, things like that. If you feel overwhelmed, I think meditating can be very beneficial to, decreasing that stress, decreasing, any feelings of being overwhelmed. I think it definitely can increase your happiness. It can increase maybe a self-awareness as well. I noticed personally when I started to meditate, I became a little bit self-aware. Being present in the moment, I was able to kind of really understand, you know, my core values and start doing some personal development, essentially.
Yeah. Wow. Very interesting. So in 2017, that's when you won a Joey Award, right? For your role in Second Generation.
Yep.
And that is if not the most prestigious award for a young performer in Canada. So congratulations.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
And then the following year, you won a role, you won a Young Artist Award.
Yes.
In LA for your role in Coming Distractions.
Yep, Birds, yeah.
Wow, man, there were a lot of really big winners there that year as well. I mean, Jacob Tremblay, Ian Armitage, that was a big year.
It was really, really cool.
Yeah, talk us through that experience and what that was like for you.
It was surreal. I honestly, it was surreal. It felt like a dream to be straight up. It felt like a dream to be, first and foremost, to be in Vancouver, because Toronto and Vancouver are the hub film locations for Canada. Mm-hmm. And I'd never been to Vancouver before at that point. So being in Vancouver in general, to be in the same place where they film shows like, you know, The Flash, and I'm a big superhero nerd. So I like The Flash and Arrow and those kind of shows. Yeah. So to be in that same kind of like area, to be around maybe some of the crew members who are maybe on that and things like that was just very, very, very cool. Very, very humbling as well. It was just a very cool experience. And same with LA. It's LA, man. So to be in LA, holy smokes. That was super cool. Very cool experience. Again, it felt like a dream. Felt like I had to pinch myself a couple times to be like, okay, am I sleeping?
Yeah. Like probably just sitting there seeing all these famous people around you. Like that must've just been out of this world.
It was very, very, very cool. It was awesome.
Yeah. So after winning awards and reaching so much success at such a young age, how do you stay grounded and how do you stay focused and kind of keep your eye on the prize and the next bigger and better thing?
I would definitely say it, for me personally, it comes down to a lot of, and I think the gym taught me this a lot, like fitness and everything, being full, but never satisfied. A big thing for me is always trying to better myself physically and mentally. I'm not to say that I'm not diminishing my self-worth. I love myself. I truly do. But I always believe I can be a better version of myself. So I always strive for that. So I think that's really what I guess keeps me grounded. I have a great support system around me as well. My parents are phenomenal. If I lift off the ground even a little bit, they make sure to put me down there. So I think it just comes down to really knowing your core values, and then also just having a good support system.
Right. Absolutely. So just before we move on here, you also had the opportunity to perform at We Day Family in 2017 to a sold out crowd at the ACC, which is no longer even called the ACC.
No, it's not, man. I'm so upset.
And you also performed alongside Johnny Orlando, as well as you also performed at We Day Ottawa too. Tell me a little bit about that experience. And what was that like for you? Because that must've been surreal as well.
That was, I should have mentioned that earlier, actually, as one of those highlights. That was an amazing moment. Being on the stage and seeing everyone when I walked out that first time was just crazy. It was absolutely crazy. At that moment when I first stepped on the stage for the ACC, and I was able to do that performance, I think was the moment where I was like, this is what I want to do. I want to bring happiness. I want to bring joy to people. I want to motivate people. I was like, this is exactly what I want to do. I think that was a big turning point for me. And it was a surreal experience, even with Ottawa as well. And just the rehearsals as well. It was just a fun experience being around all the fellow singers and Johnny himself and that kind of stuff. It was very, very cool to, have that experience with them. And we had some really fun memories taking the train for like an hour down Ottawa, taking the train back. We had some funny moments, some fun rehearsals, and it was a very, very fun time.
And how do you stay calm during an experience like that? Cause I watched the performance last night and you guys seemed like really relaxed and really just kind of like in your own element. And how do you do that?
Deep breaths. I was nervous the entire time. I think it's hard. Like for me personally, I guess, I don't ever really think I stay calm. I think it just comes down to, taking deep breaths for me, just remaining calm as much as I can. Right. 'Cause on the inside, I was freaking out, man, butterflies, everything.
I bet.
But, I think it also comes down to, I am very kind of used to, putting on that front in a way. You know, when acting, sometimes I go on set and I may not be having the best day. I may be feeling like crap, maybe something happened that day, but immediately I gotta, you know, maybe for example, be Jordan and be quirky and fun. So I have to be able to kind of switch that. So I think that helped a lot too by calming down my nerves when I was on stage.
Right.
There was a lot of people, man.
Oh yeah. Now, out of all these experiences, has there ever been a moment where you've kind of realized that you've made it, or you've kind of figured, this is it. Like, this is where I'm supposed to be.
Definitely the We Day performances. That was huge. It was amazing. Cause I actually, in grade eight or grade seven, I had the chance to actually go to Kenya, Africa with Me to We. Yeah. So I had the chance to do that, and it was a phenomenal experience as well. Learned a lot there. And so coming back right afterwards, our principal, cause I went for a school kind of trip and excursion. Mm-hmm. So our principal got us into the We Day. So I remember in grade eight going to We Day and watching that performance and saying to myself, I want to be there. Like, I want to be there. And then the moment where I stepped on stage to actually do it, I was like, wow. Wow. And it was just very, very cool.
Wow.
Stars aligned, I guess.
Yeah. Your prayers have been answered.
Yeah.
So aside from performing, you've also launched a fitness and personal training business. Tell us a little bit about that. When did it launch and how did it start?
Yeah. So it actually kind of started, I have a business partner, Munene, and he actually is in my program. So we met in my program last September, during our first year. We naturally, cause he's actually an international student from Kenya. So when he mentioned that, I saw him in the gym one day and I was like, hey man, like, I've been to Kenya too. And then we joked, we had some cool conversations. And then from there, we, started hanging out a lot, did some group assignments together. We realized that we worked very well together. And then going in a second year, or near the end of first year, the pandemic happened. And then the first lockdown happened. So I was doing school online. My work was shut down, acting, music. Well, I was still doing my music. I was still writing and that kind of stuff. But acting was very calm. So I was trying to find something to do. And Munene reached out, and we both knew that we worked well together. We're both certified personal trainers. So we decided, you know what, let's start our own company. Let's start our own movement, our own brand, and do some online training and help people. So it started then. We were on Zoom calls for about 8 hours every day, grinding out details, formulating business plans, mission statements, and things like that. And then we finally launched this past September. We kind of had a soft launch, and then we really started releasing programs in October.
Oh, wow. Congratulations, man.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
It's amazing. So talk us through the process of starting a business. What all goes into it, and how does that work, and how much time does it actually take?
Essentially, it's honest. I always find that, like, coming up with a business, and a lot of people I've heard say this, and one thing that I've definitely learned myself is you have to have a solution to a problem. Right. You have to be able to answer the question, you know, what is the problem that you're trying to solve? Right. And my partner Munene and I, we kind of realized that the problem that we wanted to solve was we see a lot of online training. It's there. The internet is flooded with different online trainers, but we find there's not a lot of online trainers that are also addressing overall wellness and also addressing, you know, healthy habits and things like that. It's strictly just the fitness, workout, nutrition, and that's it. Now, mind you, there are other places out there, but we wanted to really offer an overall wellness package to our company. So that was the problem that we wanted to solve. And as for time, I would honestly say, because it's your own business, the more time you put into it, the more time you're going to get out of it. Or the more you're going to get out of it, sorry. So if you're only able to put in a small amount of time, then you won't get as much out of it at that time. And that's okay. It all depends on who you are, what other things you're doing in life. I got very lucky at that time. That's all I could do. So I was able to put in those 8-hour days. I was able to put in maybe even 10-hour days and just grind. It probably took us, we started around May, and then we didn't open until the September. So it was a lot of formulating, photos and things like that. So definitely the more time you put into it, the more you're going to get out of it.
Interesting.
Yeah.
What were some of the initial challenges that you guys faced when you were starting your business or looking to launch?
I would say the most challenging part was coming up with how we're going to deliver programs. This is kind of more like a specific challenge to us as a personal training company, but I would say that the biggest challenge for us was really coming up with how to deliver the programs. We were having a really hard time trying to figure out whether or not we'd go the route of maybe giving PDFs to clients or whether we'd be doing an actual app, whatever the case may be. So really trying to kind of figure that out. If we were going to do an app, which one? There's so many out there. That was probably the biggest challenge. Another one would definitely be the name. That took us a while to come up with the name. We had the idea for the business. We had everything laid out. We knew what we wanted to do. We knew what we wanted to attack, and we wanted to structure. Mm-hmm. But then the name, that took us some time. We flip-flopped through a bunch, and then we finally solidified it. But those two were probably the most challenging.
Right. Especially with so many things that are out there, right? It's tough to kind of find something unique and personal for you.
Yeah, 100%.
So what is your official title, and what does your day-to-day operations kind of look like?
Title, I guess, I kind of call myself, I guess, an entrepreneur in a way. My music, I do a lot of my music myself. So I guess I kind of like own my own music in a way. And so, having my company and then acting, I have a lot of people helping me in that. My agent, for example, my mom is kind of there as well as a slash manager, momager a little bit. So I would definitely say, I guess entrepreneur, 100%. My day-to-day is essentially just kind of following the schedule, whether it be going to school, working on Fit Performance and in the company. I try to kind of balance everything within one day. So it would look like Fit Performance in the morning, then maybe school throughout the day if I have that, or work for my part-time job, any auditions that I have to do. I kind of schedule as I go.
Right.
Yeah.
And what would you say are your company's goals, or what are the official goals of Fit Performance?
we are, our biggest goal is we are trying to create a community and a group of like-minded individuals that are trying to strive for more. Like I had mentioned earlier, you know, my biggest value and my biggest thing that I try to hold dear to me is always bettering myself physically and mentally. And Munene, both of us have very similar mindsets. That's why we work well, very well together. We're also very different in like work patterns, which helps as well. But we're very similar in the sense of we're always trying to better ourselves. And so our goal with Fit Performance is, you know, right now it's online training, but we want to build a brand and build a community of people who are like-minded individuals just trying to be better versions of themselves. We want to try to motivate people. The goal hopefully would be to actually open up a facility where we can have, you know, training, we can have physiotherapists, athletic therapists, and do, different types of fitness and different worlds combined, I guess.
Wow. That's amazing, yeah. Dude.
Thank you. Yeah.
So talk to me a little bit about the services that you offer and where can people find you guys online?
Yeah. So we actually have, we have a Facebook group or a Facebook page. Sorry. We can take a lot of inquiries from there or our Instagram. So our Facebook is just Fit Performance, FIT Performance. And then our Instagram is Fit Performance CA for Canada. So those are our two pages. We're taking in DMs and things like that. We also have our personal social medias as well. Which we also will accept. Like I have a separate kind of fitness social media where I'll accept inquiries or things like that. But those are our two, if anyone wants to find us, that's where it is. We offer everything from fitness packages to nutrition guidance. We don't offer specific meal plans as Munene and myself currently aren't certified nutritionists. So we're hoping to get to that point within the next year or so. So once we get there, we're going to start implementing meal plans. But as of right now, workout programs, we have mobility and stretching programs as well, because mobility and stretching is also a huge foundation and component of fitness. Client check-ins, things like that. Daily motivation from your coaches.
It sounds like you got a little bit of something for everybody there. Like, do you have a specific demographic, or is it basically open to anybody?
Right now, to kind of like a behind the scenes, right now our focus is general population. Our goal is to work towards gearing it towards maybe, we'll have a section of Fit Performance dedicated to athletes, a section dedicated to general pop, and then maybe a bodybuilding side. Munene actually has a client who's already very advanced lifter, and he's trying to get lean for a show. So we started to kind of branch into the contest prep and bodybuilding prep side of things a little bit. But right now we're very much a general population, people who are looking to just add activity into their lives, but they're not looking to be hardcore working out 6 days a week, just to try to stay active and be healthy.
To what would you attribute your success?
I would definitely say, my parents, they really instilled into me that you have to put in the work. They instilled, it's not going to be easy. Like at an early age, I really understood that, with challenges comes growth.
Right.
I say to my clients, and I say in some of the group fitness classes that I do, is that if it doesn't challenge you, it doesn't change you. Right. So the biggest thing I think I would contribute to it is my parents kind of teaching me that and letting me understand at an early age that there's going to be challenging times. It's not going to be easy, but you grow as a human being and you become better and I guess more successful, whatever success means to you. You become more successful when you embrace those challenges, you learn from them, and you keep the eye on the prize and you just keep pushing forward. And so I think that would definitely be definitely for my parents. And now I kind of have that similar mindset. So it's definitely helped me a lot.
Right. And those are very inspirational words, because I think a lot of times failure comes from biting off too much that you can chew and jumping ahead and kind of missing all the steps to get to success. You know what I mean?
100%. It's exactly like the quote, love the journey, not the destination. Right. And that was, when I was younger, for sure, I was always focused on the destination. It was a big kind of mindset shift for me when I really started to enjoy the process and enjoy the journey. I realized it because I remember at one point when I was really young, I was like, I want to save up and I want to buy myself a PS4. And I was like, I got to do it. I bought the PS4. And then I finally did it. I was super excited. And then all of a sudden that feeling of like waiting for the PS4, that feeling, that enjoyment of like, I'm working hard. I'm a little bit closer to getting it. I'm a little bit closer. And then I got it and I was like, oh, this is awesome. And then like a couple weeks later, I was like, okay, all right, you know, and so yeah. I realized, you know what, that journey, that excitement, you know, you're not going to feel that again, right? Like we're both young, man. We're still young. We're still learning. We're still developing and growing. Like, for example, like that enjoyment and that fulfillment of like, you know, buying our first house, right? Like that journey and that growth, love that growth, love it. Because by the time you buy that first house, you're never going to feel that excitement again, you know? And I love that excitement. That's honestly what really drives me. Right. So,
yeah. Wow. That's amazing. So what are the best resources that have helped you along your path and along your journey? What, I know that you mentioned that you had a really good support system, but what other resources have really contributed to where you are today?
I would definitely say, the gym, has definitely been a big resource and a big, thing for me to kind of, it kind of keeps me, anchored in a way and keeps me motivated and driven. The gym for sure. I do like to do a lot of my own personal development. So whether it be podcasts and listening to people discuss and things like this, opening up my eyes to different concepts, different ideas and theories, as well as just reading. I like to read a lot of like motivational books and things like that. I'm currently reading a book, 75 Hard by Andy Frisella. And he discusses, you know, building a tough mindset. So that's something that I'm reading right now. And, I think those would be definitely amazing resources, that have helped me, especially throughout the past couple months. I feel like I've really, really progressed with those resources.
Yeah. So you just mentioned reading, and obviously reading is very key in becoming successful. What other books would you recommend to people who are trying to reach the same level of success as you?
First and foremost, if you can get the 75 Hard book, it's phenomenal. I would definitely check it out. There was one book that I read a couple months ago, and I can't for the life of me think of the title. It was a PDF that was given to me from my brother. My brother read it and then he sent it to me. The gentleman who wrote it, you've probably seen him before. He's all over socials right now with his motivation. He was a SEAL. I did SEAL training. He went through the boot camp about twice, was very overweight, became to a very fit individual. And he has a book discussing, you know, motivation, how to push through challenging times and things like that. So that was definitely a book that I would highly recommend. When I get the name, I will send it to you.
Yes, please.
I'll get that name and I'll 100% send it to you.
Awesome.
And as well as that 75 Hard. If for any actors listening out there, there's a book called The Craft. Phenomenal book as well. I read that. That has more to do about the craft of acting, and things like that. That definitely helped me because it kind of helped me be present. Because it talks about all about being present, being vulnerable, being open. And I've definitely kind of implemented that into some of my real world life and not just so, that's cool.
Right. Awesome. Well, thank you for sharing that. So as we all know, the morning routine helps us set the tone for the entire day and is very important, especially for successful people. Mm-hmm. Talk us through your morning routine and how does that help you during the day?
Yeah. So routine is huge for me. Like I think it's really big for everyone. Routine is just a big thing. So I try to get up and the first thing I like to do is I like to just chug water. That's also just because water is amazing for you. So get in your water, guys. Chugging my water, and then I immediately start and I go check, you know, important emails, things like that. Then I get my butt to the gym. I come back, I shower, I do a bit of cleaning around the house, whatever I need to clean, and then I kind of start my day. That's typically the morning routine for me.
Nice. So getting a little more personal, your showers, are they cold or are they warm?
So this, I've read a lot about this recently too. I've had a couple conversations. This is cool you asked that. I'll have my shower warm for the first bit. After I'm clean, after I've, you know, done your shower thing, I then switch it to cold. For like the last like 2 to 5 minutes, I'll switch it to cold water. And that really refreshes me. It wakes me up. It is very much proven to very, very beneficial for the human body. That's last 2 to 5 minutes is when I crank it over to the cold.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. Cause I just recently read that too. Well, yeah. But the past few days I've just started cold showers because I just read somewhere that obviously is important. So I just started that, and actually it's not too bad. Like after the first couple of seconds, you kind of get used to it and then you're fine. Right.
Yeah. Have you noticed a difference yet?
I don't know. Maybe. I don't know.
It's fine. If you just start, it'll take some time. I've noticed personally just a little bit more energy when I'm up in the morning. I try to get up around like 6-7, just depending on what I have. But I'm very much not a morning person. It's very hard for me to get up. Cranking it to cold definitely is a refresher in the morning.
Yeah, absolutely. Now that I'm reflecting a little bit, like I feel like my work days last longer. I probably can go a little bit further in the day besides having to crash and watch Netflix, you know?
Yeah, for sure. 100%. Or that afternoon crash.
Yeah.
Up early.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I've definitely noticed a significant difference in that as well with the cold showers and the water, drinking lots of water.
Yes, drinking lots of water, especially being at home during the pandemic, right? You're so close to your bed and so close to your relaxing space. It's kind of tough to peel yourself over to your work area and kind of keep going for the day.
100%. It's definitely a challenging thing. My place is actually, I'm in a small studio apartment and it's a Murphy bed style. So my bed is right there. So that's probably the biggest challenge that I found throughout the pandemic is trying to stay here at like my workstation, doing my work, assignments, whatever I have to do. Mm-hmm. My bed's right there, man.
Yeah, so me too, man.
If I'm tired, it's so easy for me to just be like, I'm gonna go take a 5-minute nap. That nap turns into an hour.
right.
So one thing I always try to recommend to people is honestly just like always having a cold shower, putting yourself in a state of uncomfortability. There's three types of stress. So you have like your eustress, new stress, and distress. And eustress is actually considered good stress. This is the stress that we feel when we have an assignment and we're stressed about the assignment. We're not stressed because we did it last minute. That's distress. That's not the best for us. But eustress is that, you know, we care about the assignment. We want to have a good grade. We want to make sure everything's perfect. It's actually good for us because that stress drives us and motivates us. So I think getting yourself into an uncomfortable zone can help you, you know, with that good stress and striving for more and that kind of stuff. I found with the pandemic, everyone's getting comfortable because we're at our homes, right?
Right.
And if we get too comfortable, then we get more relaxed. We start to settle. So it's just constantly getting uncomfortable, you know?
Absolutely. So just before we wrap up here, what advice could you give to people during this time in a pandemic to kind of stay motivated and keep their routines going and to kind of keep their days full?
Yeah, 100%. I guess that the three things I would say are to really understand your core values. It's almost like a business, right? When you're starting a business, you need to know your mission statement. You need to know your core values. Even as a person, it's really beneficial to know your core values and what you value most. Understand your goals. Know where you want to be, set SMART goals, be realistic with your goals. Routine is huge, especially during a pandemic, right? Everyone's losing the routine. So if you can formulate your own routine, maybe every time, like at one time of the day, you have your cold shower. Every morning, the first thing you do is maybe make your bed, you know, setting a routine for yourself can be huge to staying motivated. One thing I can recommend to people out there is, I actually have it right now. I wish you could see it. I have sticky notes all over the place. If an outsider looked in, you'd probably think I was crazy. But all of these sticky notes are essentially just, you know, there's no shortcuts. Hard work, consistency, visualizing your goals. And I actually have a few sticky notes on my bathroom because after I make my bed, I go and I brush my teeth right away, like we naturally do, right? And the first thing I see in the morning is those sticky notes saying, you know, there's no comfort in the growth zone, right? Keep pushing forward, you know, always strive to be the best version of yourself. So then the first thing that I see in the day is that, and that it kind of sets the day for me, sets the tone. So really write down your goals, write down what you want to achieve, write these things down and make sure you have it in a place where you can see it every day and you can look at it to remind yourself, are you making the necessary steps to get there? Are you putting in the work? Are you putting in the consistency? If you're not reaching it, analyze, review, self-reflection, understand, you know, what did you do different this morning? What did you what did you do in your routine that was different today?
Right.
That didn't get you to that goal, right?
Absolutely. It's very interesting that you mentioned sticky notes. I have sticky notes everywhere too. And actually I have my morning routine plastered on my mirror, just like you mentioned, because that's the first thing that I see in the morning.
Yes. Yeah. It's a great way to be. It really sets the tone. Really, really sets the tone for the day.
It does. And you kind of feel like crap if you don't accomplish all those goals.
for sure. And writing down to-do lists too, like sticky notes are great. If you don't have sticky notes, go out and get sticky notes. They're so beneficial.
And they're so cheap too. Like just get them.
Yeah, just get them. Or if anything, you can, if you have a computer, download the virtual sticky notes.
Ah,
I mean, it's on the computer, so you won't be able to really see it. It's not like you can put it in the bathroom.
Yeah.
But it's still something, right?
Well, what does success mean to you in general?
Success to me, being able to do what I love and maintain some sort of financial comfort, as well as maintaining my values, not losing track of who I am, not losing track of my values, but also still doing what I love. I think that would definitely be, I guess, success to me.
And if you could go back in time and talk to an even younger version of yourself, what kind of advice would you give to yourself?
Keep pushing through. Just keep going. Keep moving forward. Stay present. It's going to be all right. Because I definitely remember when I was younger, I would always be like, is this going to work out? I would get exhausted. I would get tired of the challenging times that would occur. They'd beat me down. And I'd let them win. There were a lot of times where I gave up on a lot of things. And if I could definitely speak to a younger version of myself, I wouldn't necessarily, I wouldn't tell the future. I wouldn't try to, you know, tell myself to invest in something. I would just say, keep pushing through. Just keep pushing through. There is always a light at the end of the tunnel. That uncomfortability and that challenge will help you grow. So accept it, use it as fire and as fuel to keep moving forward.
Hmm. And how did you get through some of your most toughest times in life?
I would definitely say fitness and music, doing what I loved and remembering why I love to do them. They're very few therapeutic for me. I'm very open about it, but two years ago, my mom suffered she has an eating disorder. So she was actually in an inpatient program. We almost lost her. So it was a very challenging time. So I guess just really understanding. And for me at that time, when everything seemed super challenging and I wasn't really doing much acting, I was just putting all my efforts into my mom and making sure she was okay. I was also playing all of my music. I would play guitar for hours and hours and hours. I would go to the gym. I'd work out. And I just did what I loved to push through those times.
Hmm. Well, thank you very much for sharing that. And everybody can find Matthew online, Facebook and Instagram. His links will be in the description. Thank you so much for joining me, Matthew.
No problem at all. I'm sorry to end it off on a little bit of a sadder note. I apologize, but yeah. Thank you so much. Thanks for having me, brother. Thank you, everyone, for listening. And I'm super excited to hopefully meet all of you.
Absolutely. You can follow Matthew Edmondson on social media and check out some of his music and covers on Instagram at Tristan Matthews Official. You can find all of his links in the show description. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to The Jordan James Show. And while you're there, please give us a nice rating and review. We're available for free on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and wherever you find your favorite podcasts. You can also find us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and at thejordanjamesshow.com for more exclusive content. I'm your host, Jordan James, and we'll see you next time as we continue to discover the path to success on The Jordan James Show.
During COVID-19, during the pandemic, there was a lot of chaos going on. And we thought, what could we do throughout this period of time where instead of focusing on these problems, we could think of an opportunity?
My name is Matthew Edmondson. I am co-founder and head coach at Fit Performance.
My name is Manana Bijua. I'm 21 years old, and I am the co-founder and head coach here at Fit Performance.
We initially met on our first day at fitness and health promotion at Durham College. Throughout that, we started to study together a little bit more. And we really noticed that we had a really good work connection. We could work well together.
So we started brainstorming. You know, Matthew and myself would hop on calls every day, trying to think, create an idea. What can we do to really make an impact that can also change people's lives? And that's when we decided to come up with Fit Performance, which is now our company that we are very proud and very happy to bring to you guys. Company offers personalized tailored workout programs specific to your body that are safe, efficient, effective, and enjoyable.
We also have our training insights, which dive into the science behind some of our movements and what's happening exactly to your body when you're working out, when you're doing these types of things.
There you go, come on. Squeeze that back, come on. Come on, Matthew.
What sets us apart is our focus on lifestyle and mindset and training insights. We believe that focusing more on health as a holistic view and overall, you know, physical and the mental aspect of things, focusing on overall wellness, we think not only provides you with more information and knowledge, but it helps with a better transformation and an overall healthy lifestyle. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. If you're interested on taking the first step to an everlasting journey of growth, physically, mentally, and emotionally,
feel free to reach out to us on our social media. We'll link our information at the end of the video, and we'd be more than happy to help you set and achieve your health and fitness goals by leveraging our functional improvement techniques. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your time, and we hope to connect with you soon. Take care.